Hello students, today in this video I am going to teach you chapter 4 in the kingdom of fools. We have done first part of this chapter. In the first part we saw that how in the kingdom of fools both the king and the ministers were fools, and the kingdom is ruled by a foolish king and his foolish ministers. So once they order that night should be considered as a day and vice versa, and the day would be considered as a night. So one day a guru and his apple visit the kingdom, and they are surprised the entire kingdom asleep during the day. So the guru immediately the kingdoms with his disciples as he feels danger in staying in such a kingdom. But the disciple wouldn't move with guru. He decided to stay there. So suddenly there was an incident in the town. One day a thief broke rich merchant's house by making a big hole in the wall, but as he was going out the wall fell on him and killed him on the spot. So now the brother of the thief went to the court for justice. So the king heard the case and found guilty of the thief's spot death. But the merchant put the blame on the bricklayer who had built the wall. The bricklayer pleading the king to punish the dancing girl who distracted his attention by going up and down the street all day with angry jingling. Now women was brought to the court, and now she blame on goldsmith. Now the story is going on. One person is blaming to another person, and this person is blaming to someone else. So how the story is going? So to know more story, and let's find out what will happen ahead in the story. Let's start reading the chapter. Goldsmith named the merchant, and he was none other than the original owner of the house whose wall had fallen. Now justice had come full circus, thought the king, back to the merchant when he was rudely summoned back to the court. He arrived crying, "It wasn't me, but my father who ordered the jewelry. He is dead. I'm innocent." So the goldsmith named the merchant. The goldsmith said that the merchant was the same merchant whose wall had fallen, and now the justice has come full circuit. Means that the story ended at the same person from whom it had started. So the thief died under the wall of the same merchant whose jewelry this goldsmith was making. So once again the merchant was summoned to the court, and he was crying and he was saying that he knew that the king was foolish. Now he would give him death sentence. So now he said that it was not me who had ordered the jewelry. It was his father. It was my father who ordered for jewelry, and his dad. He was right. And I am innocent. I am not a guilty person. I haven't done something wrong. मैंने कुछ गलत नहीं किया है. It was my father who had ordered. जिसने ऑर्डर दिया था ज्वेलरी बनाने के लिए. मैंने नहीं दिया था ये ऑर्डर ज्वेलरी बनाने के लिए. But the king consulted his minister, ruled decisively. It's true. Your father is true murderer. He's dead. But somebody would be punished in his place. You have inherited everything from that criminal father of yours, his riches as well as sins. I knew at once, even when I first set eyes on you, that you were at the root of his horrible crime. You must die. The king consulted his minister and gave the decision that the merchant was the murderer. It is true, your father is true murderer. The thief died because of your father. And he is dead, but somebody must be punished in his place. But your father was not alive, but someone had to be punished for the crime. So you have inherited everything from that criminal fathers of yours, his riches as well as his sin. So he said that the merchant's son who had inherited everything from his father. So you would have to take the punishment for the doing this as well. So you have taken everything from your father, your good work, his property, and now you have to take sin also. you have to take punishment for his wrongdoings also. So I knew at once, even when I first set on you, that you were at the root of his horrible crime. You must die. So he said that, even king said that, he has seen the merchant for the first time. And at that moment he realized, or I first set on you, I realized that you were at the root of the horrible crime, that he had a feeling, that the king had a feeling that he was a culprit and you must die, you must be punished. So king announced that now the merchants would have to die, because ultimately he had committed crime. He ordered a new stick to be made ready for the execution, as the servant sharpened the stick and got it ready for the final impaling of the criminal. It occurred to the minister that the rich merchant was somehow too thin to be properly executed on the stake. He appealed to the king's common sense, the king too worried about it. So now he ordered a new stick to be made. King ne order diya ek naya stick banaya jaye, ek sharp pointed jo use kiya jayega execution ke liye. Execution mean killing of the person officially kisi ko marna. So as the servant sharpened the stick, jaise hi servant sharp kar rahe the stick ko, this new weapon got ready. So final impaling of the criminal, impaling mein to put a sharp and pointed post or something, kisi par marna, kisi ko weapon se marna. So it occurred to the minister ke dimag mein aaya that the rich merchant was somehow too thin to be properly executed on the stick. So minister thought that this merchant was so too thin, ये बहुत मर्चेंट बहुत पतला है, ही कुड नॉट बी एग्जीक्यूटेड इन दिस वे, इस तरीके से उसको नहीं मारा जा सकता है. एंड ही टोल्ड दिस टू द किंग, दैट किंग गॉट वरिड. नाउ ही अपील टू द किंग्स कॉमन सेंस, उसने किंग को कहा कि इस मर्चेंट को तो हम नहीं मार सकें क्योंकि ये बहुत पतला है, ही वॉज टू थिन टू बी एग्जीक्यूटेड. सो किंग गॉट वरिड. What shall we do? He said. Well, suddenly it struck him that all they needed to do was to find a man fat enough to fit the stake. The servants were immediately sent all over the town looking for a man who would fit the stake. Then eyes fell on the disciple who had fattened himself for months on bananas and wheat and ghee. So the king thought, what shall we do now? अब हमें क्या करना चाहिए? He said. When suddenly it struck him idea that all they needed to do was to find a fit man enough to fit the stake. So king got an idea. King को एक idea that they should catch a hold a man who was fit enough to be executed with the stick. तो उन्हें एक ऐसा fit इंसान select करना है, एक human being search करना है जो इस stick पर आ जाए, आसानी से fit हो जाए ताकि वो उसको मार सके. So the servant were immediately sent all over the town looking for the man who would fit the stick. So the servant were sent to all over the kingdom. Now the merchant was not able to put to the death because he was too thin to be executed. So now the servants were sent around the kingdom to look for a man who was fit enough to be executed with the stick. So they find a guru's disciple. Finally they found the guru's disciple, the student who had become very fat because of the overeating. He had eaten so many things throughout the month and he became fat because of overeating. What have I done wrong? I'm innocent, I'm a sannyasi, he cried. That may be true, but it's the royal decree that we should find a fit man enough to fit the stake, they said, carried him to the place of execution. He remembered his wise guru's word. This is a city of fools. You don't know what they will do next. While he was waiting for death, he prayed to his guru in his heart, asking him to hear his cry. Wherever he was, the guru saw everything in a vision. He had magic powers. He could see far. He could see the future as he could see the present and the past. He arrived at once to save his disciple who had got himself into such a scrap through love of food. So what I have done wrong? So the disciple said that, what I have done something wrong? I hadn't done anything wrong. Maine to kuch galat nahi kiya. I'm an innocent person. I'm a sannyasi. He cried. He was shouting. That may be true, ये सच हो सकता है, but it's a royal decree that we should find a man fit enough to fit the stick. But we should got the order from our king that we should find a man who would be the fit enough to fit the stick. तो हमें एक ऐसे मैन को ढूंढना है कि जो कि फिट आ जाए स्टैक में, इसलिए हमें ऐसा मैन चाहिए। डिग्री मीन ऑर्डर, रॉयल डिग्री का ऑर्डर है, द किंग का ऑर्डर है कि हमें ऐसा मैन चाहिए जो कि वहाँ पर फिट हो। सो दे वर ऑर्डर्ड, आर किंग ऑर्डर्ड टू अस टू कैच होल्ड ऑफ अ मैन हु गुड बी एग्जीक्यूटेड विद द स्टैक एंड ही वॉज फिट फॉर इट एंड दैट इज़ वाई दे वर टेकिंग हिम अलोंग, इसीलिए वो उसे लेकर जा रहे हैं। सो he remembered this wise guru's words, this is a city of fool, you don't know what they will do next, while he was waiting for death. So suddenly the disciple is reminded of guru's words, usko guru ke words yaad aate hain, and guruji who was a wise person, he was a wise person and he said that this is a city of fools. And Guruji said that it was a city of fools and they could harm us also, और हमें भी नुकसान पहुँचा सकते हैं, and you don't know what they will do next, and they were taking him along to execute him, they don't know what they will do next, वो आगे क्या करेंगे हमें नहीं पता है। While he was waiting for death, he prayed to his guru in his heart, asking him to hear his wherever he was. The guru saw everything in a vision, he had magic power, he could see far, he could see the future, he could see the present and the past. He arrived at once to save his disciple who had got himself into such a scrap through love of food. So while he was waiting for the death, wo wait kar raha tha death ke liye finally, but the helpless disciple also prayed to his guru and asked him to come to rescue, aur se pray kar raha tha ki please aa jaiye aur mujhe bacha lijiye. And the guru had a special powers, guru has a special power and he visualized the, he got the message of disciple due to his magical power and he could see everything, he could see the future, he could see the present and he could see the past. So he arrived at once to save his disciple, so he arrived there, the guru arrived there to save his disciple, the guru wahan aa gaya use apne student ko bachane ke liye, who got himself into such a scrap, jo इट्स डिफ़िकल्ट सिचुएशन में फंस गया, स्क्रैप इज़ अ डिफ़िकल्ट सिचुएशन। सो द डिसाइपल वॉज ट्रैप्ड इन अ डिफ़िकल्ट सिचुएशन, सीरियस सिचुएशन, हु हैड गॉट हिमसेल्फ टू अ स्क्रैप सिचुएशन, वाई, बिकॉज ही वॉज लवर ऑफ फूड, सो द गुरु कम हैड कम टू रेस्क्यू फ्रॉम दिस सिचुएशन। As soon as he arrived, he scolded the disciple and told him something in a whisper. Then he went to the king and addressed him, "O wisest of the king, who is the greater, the guru or the disciple?" "Of course, the guru, no doubt about. Why do you ask? Then put me to the stake first. Put my disciple to death after me." So, as soon as he arrived, just as the guru arrived there, जैसे ही वहाँ गुरु आते हैं, as the guru met his disciple, he scolded the disciple. And he started shouting to the disciple and told him something in whisper. And he said something him, उसे धीरे से कुछ कहा, whispering, he whispered something in his ear. Then he went to the king, और फिर king के पास गए and addressed him, और उसे कहा, "O wisest of king." And now the guru tried to trap the king in his word. अब guru उसको अपनी बातों में लेकर आ रहे हैं. So he asked him, "You are a great king. Who was a greater between a guru and his disciple? You are a greater. So the guru or the disciple?" So the he asked the king that, "Hum dono mein se kaun great hai? Main ya disciple?" So he asked that question to the king. So king replied, "Of course, the guru. No doubt of it. Why do you ask me? Aap ye kyun pooch rahe hain? Then put me to the stake first. Put my disciple to death after me." So he asked that. So guru said that for this reason the king must be executed him before executing my disciple. तो आपको मुझे पनिशमेंट देना चाहिए, मेरे डिसाइपल को नहीं पनिशमेंट देना चाहिए आपको, क्योंकि मैं ग्रेट हूँ तो मुझे आपको परमिशन देना है। When the disciple heard this, he understood and began to clamor, "Me first, you brought me here first and put me to death, me first, not him." So when the disciple heard this, जब disciple ने सुना तो he understood, वो भी समझ गया, एंड बिगन टू क्लैमर, और वो चिल्लाने लगा, क्लैमर मी शॉर्ट डिस्टर्बेंस, मी फर्स्ट, मुझे मारो, यू ब्रॉट मी हियर फर्स्ट, क्योंकि आप मुझे लेकर आए, पुट मी डेथ फर्स्ट नॉट हिम, मुझे मारिए, आप इन्हें नहीं मारेंगे. So he started arguing that who would die first. The king got confused. Now the guru and the disciple now got into a fight. Dono ladne lag gaye. Who should go first? The king was puzzled by his behavior. Now king was confused. He asked the guru, "Why do you want to die? We chose him because we needed a fit man for the stick. Why?" So the king asked to the man, to the guru, that why you ask for death? आप मरना क्यों चाहते हैं? So बिकॉज हमने इसे तो इसलिए मारा था, वी चोज हैम बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट अ फेट मैन, बिकॉज वी वॉन्टेड अ फेट मैन हु कुड बी एग्जीक्यूटेड विद द स्टिक, दैट्स वाई वी कॉट हिम. सो यू शुडंट आस्क सच क्वेश्चन, पुट मी टू दैट फर्स्ट, रिप्लाई द गुरु. गुरु ने कहा, द गुरु रिफ्यूज टू रिप्लाई, उसे रिप्लाई देने से मना कर दिया, उसे सिंपल सा कहा, ही सैड दैट ही वॉन्टेड टू डाई बिफोर हिज डिसाइपल. Why there is a mystery? As a wise man, you must make me understand. आप तो बहुत समझदार इंसान हैं. Now you should, you are an intelligent man, and you should tell me why you want to die. आपको मुझे बताना चाहिए कि आप क्यों मरना चाहते हैं. So the king felt there was a mystery behind it. So guru wanted to die before his disciple, and he was eager to die, and there must be some reason behind it. Will you promise to you to put me to death if I tell you? So the guru asked the king to promise him that he could execute him first if he would tell the secret about why he wanted to be executed first. तो उसने गुरु ने किंग से कहा, उसे वो बताए, प्रॉमिस करे कि अगर वो उसे रीज़न बताएगा तो डेफिनेटली वो उसे पहले ही एग्जीक्यूटेड करेगा, उसे मारेगा, उसे पनिशमेंट दी जाएगी. The guru took him aside out of the servants he assured and whispered to him, and do you know why we want to die right now? The two of us, we have been all over the world, but we have never found a city like this or a king like you. The stag is the stag of the god of justice, and it is new. It has never had a camel on it. Whoever dies first will be reborn as the king of this country, and whoever go next will be the future minister of the country. So the king promised that he would execute him first, but then the guru took the king aside. Wo guru usko side mein le jata hai aur wo batata hai, slowly told him that they had roamed around the whole world. Wo pure world mein ghume hain, lekin unhe aapke jaisa kingdom wahan kahin nahi mila hai. He had not seen a city just like your city and the king like you. The stack is the stack of the god, aur ye jo stack hai, it is a stack of a god. He added that the stake which they would use to kill the disciple, this was a stake of justice. Ye god ka stack hai, and it is a new, as it was a new, it had not killed any animal, kisi criminal ko nahi mara hai. So whoever die on it, jiski bhi se death hogi, further he said that one who die first on the stack would be reborn and he would be the king of this kingdom. To wo is pe इस कंट्री का किंग बनेगा. बट टेलिंग ऑल दिस ही ट्राइंग टू कैच द किंग इन हिज ट्रैप. वो ये सब झूठ बोलकर किंग को अपने जाल में फंसाना चाह रहा था. सो एंड हूएवर गोज नेक्स्ट विल बी द फ्यूचर मिनिस्टर ऑफ द कंट्री. सो वी आर सिक ऑफ आवर असिस्टिक लाइफ, इट वुड बी नाइस टू एंजॉय आवरसेल्फ एज किंग एंड मिनिस्टर फॉर अ वाइल. नाउ कीप योर वर्ड माय लॉर्ड, put us to that, me first, remember. So he said that now the king, the one who would die next would be the reborn as a minister of the come. So the guru added that he was tired of this life, tired of this ascetic life, tired of sannyasi life. So now he and his disciple, jo uske disciple hai, wanted to live the life of a king. Ab wo king ki life jeena chahte hain. So whoever goes next will be the future minister of the country. So he said that the king execute him first so that he is reborn as a king, and after him the disciple, so he would be reborn as a minister. So now keep your word, now you should keep your word, aap apne words yaad rakhein, and my lord put us to that, me first, remember, and you should remember your word, and you would execute me first, so aap mujhe hi punish karenge. The king was now thrown into the deep thought He did not want to lose the kingdom off to someone else in the next round of life. He needed time. So, after listening to the guru, now king was in deep thought. अब वो बहुत ज़्यादा सोच रहा है. He did not want to lose the kingdom. वो kingdom नहीं खोना चाहता. To someone else in the next round of life. कि next round of life में उसे ये ना मिले. He needed time. उसे time चाहिए. So he ordered the execution. तो उसने order दिया execution का. पोस्टपोन कि ये जो पनिशमेंट है अभी थोड़े टाइम के लिए पोस्टपोन करते हैं टू द नेक्स्ट डे के लिए. टॉक इन सीक्रेट विद दिस मिनिस्टर और अपने मिनिस्टर से बात की. एंड ही डिड नॉट वांट दैट इन द नेक्स्ट लाइफ द किंगडम विल बी स्ट्रेस्ड अवे फ्रॉम हिम. सो ही डिस्कस दिस मैटर विद द हिज मिनिस्टर. सो इट इज़ नॉट राइट फॉर अस टू गिव आवर फ्रीडम टू अदर इन द नेक्स्ट लाइफ. लेट्स गो ऑन स्टे कासल. वी विल बी रीबॉर्न एज किंग एंड मिनिस्टर अगेन. होली मैन डोंट टेल लाइज. ही सेड द मिनिस्टर एग्री. सो द किंग टोल्ड हिज मिनिस्टर दैट ही डिड नॉट वॉन्ट दैट इन द नेक्स्ट लाइफ किंगडम विल बी टेकन अवे. सो ही सेड दैट द मैन द होली मैन डिड नॉट स्पीक लाइज. ये लोग झूठ नहीं बोलते जो सन्यासी लोग होते हैं. ही सेज दैट दे शुड फाइट फर्स्ट. So they will be reborn as a king, and after king, he would be the minister of the kingdom. So they are reborn as kingdom, as king, and as minister of their king. So he told executioner, where will send the criminals tonight? When the first man comes to you, put him to death first, then do the same to the second man. Those are my order. Don't make any mistakes. So he told the executioners that he would send the criminals right. वो रात को criminals को भेजेंगे. So firstly they should execute the person who come first. जो पहले आएगा उसे पहले मारना and then execute the second. जो बाद में आएगा उसके तो उसको मारना. So they should be careful and not make any mistake. और कोई mistake नहीं करना. That night the king and the minister went secretly to the prison, released the guru and the disciple, disguised themselves as two, and he arranged beforehand the with loyal servants were taken to the stack, promptly executed. So that night, the king and his master, the king and his master went to the prison guy, where the guru and his disciple were kept. जहाँ पर disciple guru को रखा गया था. They wore the clothes of the guru and the disciple. उन्होंने उनके कपड़े पहने. So they resembled them, disguised themselves in there as the two. जैसे वो लोग रहते हैं. So it was told the servants. As arranged beforehand with loyal servants, कहा गया था they came and took them along and put them into the stake for execution. थी उनको ले जाए जब भी वो आए. So were taken to the stake, promptly executed, और उन्हें वहाँ पर जाकर उनको execute कर दिया गया. In this way, with his intelligence, the guru was able to execute his foolish king and his foolish minister. और इस तरीके से foolish king और foolish minister की death हुई. When the dead bodies were taken down to be thrown to cross and vulture, the people panicked. They saw before them the dead bodies of the king and the minister. The city was in confusion. So when the dead bodies were taken down, जब उन्हें नीचे लाया गया, so everyone was trembling. Everyone was shocked because the dead bodies were not of the guru and disciple. क्योंकि dead body guru और disciple की नहीं थी. Instead, they were the dead bodies of the king and minister. ये dead body थी king और minister की. And now the city was in confusion. अब city में सारे लोग confused हैं. All night they mourn and discuss the future of the kingdom. Some people suddenly thought of the guru and the disciple and caught up with them as they were preparing to leave that town unnoticed. So everyone in the kingdom was mourning the death of their king and minister. तो वो लोग अपने minister और king की death का शोक व्यक्त कर रहे थे. So in the morning some people, कुछ लोग suddenly thought of the guru और disciple के बारे में सोचा, and they felt that they should go to them, उनके पास जाना चाहिए. As the guru and disciple were planning to leave the kingdom, वो लोग जा रहे थे kingdom छोड़ के, and उन्होंने वहीं जाकर उनको रोक लिया. वी पीपल नीड अ किंग एंड मिनिस्टर. हम लोगों को एक किंग और मिनिस्टर चाहिए. सर समवन, किसी ने कहा. अदर्स एग्री, और लोग भी एग्री करें. दे बैग द गुरु एंड द डिसाइपल टू बी द किंग एंड द मिनिस्टर. तो उन्होंने रिक्वेस्ट की किंग से, डिसाइपल से और गुरु से कि वो आप हमारे किंग और मिनिस्टर बन जाओ. सो द पीपल ऑफ द किंगडम थॉट दैट दे नीडेड अ किंग. सो दे रिक्वेस्टेड द गुरु एंड डिसाइपल टू बी द न्यू किंग एंड द मिनिस्टर ऑफ द किंगडम. सो It didn't take many arguments to persuade the disciple, but it longer to persuade the guru. ज़्यादा time लगा किसको समझाने में? गुरु को समझाने में, because he was not ready to be a king. But disciple was quickly agreed. एंड इट्स टुक सम टाइम टू मेक द गुरु एग्री अपॉन दिस. थोड़ा टाइम लगा गुरु को समझाने में. दे फाइनली एग्री टू रूल द किंगडम ऑफ द फुलिश किंग. और वो फाइनली एग्री करते हैं. सो द गुरु एग्री टू बी द किंग ऑफ किंगडम. वो एग्री करता है. एंड द सिली मिनिस्टर. और वो सिली मिनिस्टर ऑन द कंडीशन दैट दे कुड चेंज ऑल द ओल्ड लॉज. लेकिन वो इस पर रेडी होते हैं कि वो सारे लॉज जो हैं सिटी के वो चेंज कर देंगे. सो द गुरु एग्रीड एंड एवरी वन वुड वर्क इन डे एंड स्लिप एट नाइट ऑन द कंडीशन फ्रॉम दैट. एंड ऑल्सो द कॉस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स वुड बी वेरी फ्रॉम then on night would be night again and the day would be day again. You could get nothing from a guru. It become like any other place and the cost of the things would vary and not be one guru or for anything as was the system earlier. Or sab cheezon ki alag alag rate hoga unki quantity ke according वेरी होगा. डिफरेंट डिफरेंट होगा. सिर्फ सिंगल डिडू नहीं होगा. सो इट वुड बी लाइक एनी अदर प्लेस व्हेन एवरीथिंग हैड डिफरेंट रेट्स. जो सब चीज़ों का डिफरेंट रेट होता है. फाइनली द गुरु वट कन्वर्टेड द किंगडम ऑफ द फूल्स इनटू अ नॉर्मल किंगडम. और जो किंगडम था फूल्स का अब वो फाइनली एक नॉर्मल किंगडम बन गया.